Hello and welcome back, or welcome to India, New Delhi, for the first ISSF World Cup of the 27th season. The athletes for the 50-meter rifle three possessions men are just about to be introduced. For the last couple of hours, they've been battling it out in the qualifications, and now the action's going to start. I'm Matthew Layton. Dane Sampson is with me. How are you?
Good, thank you.
We'll just watch and listen to Jamie, who's going to introduce the athletes. So he's going to go through the eight athletes in their firing positions. So Sun Jian going for China. They've had a spectacular start to the meeting so far. Now here's Tortungpanich for Thailand, shooting position B. Yamashita from Japan in his fifth World Cup final. Best result was sixth in Fort Benning. Hui Chi Sung, big round of applause. Good CV as well. Switzerland have a participant in the final, Yang Lochbihler, as we've heard, present at Rio. Peter Sidi from Hungary, one of the real characters in this sport, came second in the 10-meter air rifle a couple of days ago. Sanjeev Rajput, I was in the qualification arena when on his last shot he qualified, and there was a big cheer went up.
Yeah, the Indians were really happy.
So the third China out of three to make the final, Pang Jongkui. Well, his microphone's cut off, so we'll see. We're just introducing a gentleman from Bahrain who's going to be the jury member. Gets to stand up twice. It's a toss for India, having a busy time. Very good job there. So they're about ready to start. Their heart will be beating. Well, hopefully.
Well, they're all experienced shooters, so I'm sure they'll know how to handle themselves.
Well, we'll have to see over the next 45 minutes or so. Qualifications this morning. Yourself, you tell me you weren't particularly happy with your performance. Just a few seconds, just to sum us up for your friends and family back home. What? How was your day?
No, it wasn't very enjoyable. I mean, the conditions were a little bit difficult. There was times that you would shoot and it was just a bit confusing about where the shot was going and how it was getting there, but I was not very happy with my shoot today, so, but there's plenty more competitions to come, and I've prone in a couple of days, so that'll be good to have another chance.
Well, thanks so much for joining us today. We do have three athletes in the People's Republic of China. They've won four gold medals so far. They're really putting forward an outstanding performance, and arguably this is not their top team.
No, I believe this is, I think, maybe juniors. They're all very young team, so this could be like a trial for them and experience some World Cups.
Peter Sidi so far, he's the only representative in the whole competition from Hungary. Come out with his coach. He's been very active. He took a silver medal in the 10 meters. He was then in the final yesterday of the mixed 10 meter, and today he's going for it the best he can. We started off with Pan Junghui with 10.9.
That's always a good way to start.
So just to confirm, we are having three series of five shots in the kneeling position, and this is to be done in 200 seconds, correct me if I'm wrong.
200 seconds, yes. It's about 3 minutes 20.
And is that enough?
Yeah, that's plenty of time. I mean, kneeling, you can get the shots out really quite quickly as fast as prone, so it's plenty of time.
So any early signs apart from the Chinese are firing particularly well?
There's a couple of good tens, and I think it's really important to just shoot consistently. It doesn't have to be amazing, but if you can shoot consistently and not have too many really bad shots, then that'll count a lot for later on when it gets to standing and when all the scores have added up.
Of course, these athletes, by definition, they're here. They're good at all three different positions, but some of them will favour others.
Correct, yes.
It tends to even itself out over the competition.
When it gets to standing is when really things get decided. I mean, it's the most unstable position. So it's always the decider to see who will come up on top.
So we do have Sun Jian, who has started with a 52.1. Are you happy with that?
52.1 is good, definitely. That's really solid.
Thailand putting in a 50.3, so it's a significant lead after the first round of five shots. We'll have a summary from Jamie after the athletes have finished their five shots.
You definitely want to be shooting above probably 50.5, 51 to be comfortable position with kneeling.
So totally all athletes will have 40 shots, which is 15 in kneeling, 15 in prone, and then at least 10 in standing. So we're moving through the competition. As you can see, People's Republic of China have the top spot at the moment, but also taking eighth position. And Hui, who is in eighth at the moment, he has five golds in World Cup, so he knows how to pull it back, I guess.
The long way to go with this final, so... Anything could happen.
Off air, you're telling me it's a great frustrating position.
Yeah, it's very enjoyable when it's going well, but it can be incredibly frustrating when it's not going well.
Go into more depth.
Well, when it's going well, it's because I guess you're sort of sitting there, and it just feels so nice when you're letting off good shot after, and you can get a good rhythm. And it just goes and goes and goes, and they just go really nice tight group, like in prone. But when it's not going well, they're just in random places, and you can see it through the recoil. Instead of going up nice and like this, it'll to the sides and all over the joint.
Sun Jian, on his biography, it's a completely clean sheet, so we don't know much about him, but he certainly knows how to put some good scores in.
That's China. They've probably got another 10 people that could shoot just as well at home. If you could enter 10 people, they could probably enter 10 people and fill up the final.
So we're moving through. Most athletes have taken eight shots now with Sun Jian, a good score. And we did see another 10.9. Peter Sidi this time has decided to grace us with his extraordinary talent.
He can always shoot a good score. He's one of the greats, particularly for 3P and air rifle positions. So he's going
to be daunting when it's standing position as well.
Yeah, he can definitely put them in the middle in standing. So it'll be good to see what happens.
Switzerland, do you know much about Lochbihler?
He's hard worker. You see him, every time I see him, any competition, he's always doing dry. All the Swiss guys seem to be doing a lot of dry. But yeah, really solid shooter. He's just always up around 11-17 and above. And yeah, and still very young as well. So I'm sure he'll be around at the top for quite a long time to come.
And we've seen so far, we've seen India putting an athlete in most finals. We had a medal in the women's 10 meter, a bronze medal, which was great. And we had a couple of close things. But with the crowd, which is, it's a good crowd, isn't it? It's a partisan crowd, but it's the good crowd. They're delighted by that. So second, so we've had 10 shots so far. Sun Jian from China, the unknown quantity, 25 years old, is leading the ball at the moment with 103.5. How does that stand in world quality?
Yeah, that's really good, really solid, particularly in the final. That'll help a lot for later on when it comes to standing. And
so one more series through. Can you see anyone from you? Can we obviously have a great. We can see the screen the same as everyone else, but we're actually 5 meters from the shooters. Can you see any giveaways that people are on form, or are they all got their poker faces on?
They all look pretty much the same as when they're in the qualification. No one's fidgeting too much or seems to be having too much trouble. But what's happening on the inside could be another story, so it's hard to see that.
Do you guys discuss how you feel between you, or is it one of those things? Yeah, it's really internal.
No, absolutely. I mean, we'll always. That's. I mean, it's a good way. Good thing about the sport, and it's definitely a good way to get better. Is we, you know, talk to each other and work from each other's experiences, especially the ones that are the people that are close. You know, got a lot of good friends in the sport, and we're always talking about the ins and outs and helping out each other.
Yang Lochbihler just had a 10.7, so you said he's working hard. It's obviously paying off in his favour. But San Jian from the People's Republic of China is still leading at the moment, from Thailand closely behind.
They're both shooting really good groups at the moment for this five-shot series.
And do they, clearly on our screen we can see the groupings of the athletes. Some athletes, I guess, will be analysing that and finding out what's going on.
Yeah, of course. I mean, you mean from outside or the actual shooters?
The actual shooters.
The shooters. Of course, after every shot, you're evaluating it. In the final, you know, there's not too much time to be thinking about it. You're just trying to do, just shoot good shots and what you see through the sights and make sure that's information is what you're looking for. And then if it is, then it'll be good on the screen as well.
So the mechanics look after themselves. Yep. Sun Jian, after the kneeling position, which is now finished, is 155, significantly above anyone else, 2 whole points above Thailand at this stage.
And that's like textbook excellent score, what you want to have after kneeling. You know, kneeling 155 and then prone 157.5 and then standing like 152.5. That's like a perfect world, I guess you could say.
Yeah.
Is what you'd be looking for.
Okay. So they now have 7 minutes to change. We'll see how many images we actually have on this, but this is something that you do in your sleep, I guess.
You have to have a routine, you have to have a plan to do it, so then you don't forget anything, then it keeps you calmer, because obviously you're moving and you don't have much time, so you need to move quickly to change everything, but you also want to stay calm like in your body so that you're settled for when you start prone as well. So if you have like a good routine and
how long do you want to take to so you have your gun, which is set up for your kneeling.
Yep.
What are you actually changing? Talk about you. What would you be changing?
I have to change the butt plate, cheekpiece and the sights. Hand stop is basically in the same spot, so it's just, and it's all quite quick action things on there, so you can change it over pretty quickly. So you want to be done in about 3 minutes, 3.5 minutes,
right?
So that you've got, you know, four minutes. It should be enough for you to be sighted in and prone.
Is that to have a possibility of lie down and control your heartbeat?
Just have your body settle, have all the tensions in the position settle, and be ready. You know, the sighters are not just for getting the sights in the right spot, but for getting your body settled in the right spot as well.
We'll see how they're going forward. If you've just tuned in, we are coming to you live from New Delhi. Well, just slightly south of New Delhi, in fact, in beautiful India. Dane Sampson has made the qualifications, not made the final. So by definition, we've chosen him as our guest to analyse what's going on. I say very pleased to see him there. Yeah, we had to stop speaking for a second because Gaganadan wanted to take a photograph. Yeah,
that's a big camera.
Well, he's a very active character because he Gagan actually made the opening oath for the athletes. He was my guest commentator for the first two air rifle events. I think he's going to be on Jamie's next segment, which is the change from the prone to the standing. And he looks like he's got a very smart camera. So he's obviously one of the unofficial. There, he's on the screen. You can see Gagan there, yep, with his very smart camera. So Jamie has probably a few hundred audience here. He's just keeping them warmed up, showing them what's going on. Say, if you have just tuned in, we are just finishing the kneeling position. So that's 15 shots have come out. And so far, it is Shang Jian from China, who's a very impressive 155, leading Thailand at the moment with Nappers. Tortungpanich is second position, 2 points behind. We then have People's Republic of China, Pang Jui in third, Yamashita fourth, Rajput, Sanjeev Rajput, which keeps the local crowd very, very happy, in fifth. Switzerland has an athlete in the final with Yang Lochbihler in sixth. Then it is Shishen, who has 5 World Cup medals to his name, goals in fact. And then finally, Peter Sidi is not to be counted out because, as you mentioned a couple times before, he's a very good standing athlete.
Absolutely.
So we can see the images in front of us. Most athletes are now in their position. There's Jamie asking how many World Cups is it hosted? There you go, just keeping them happy. This is it's a typical question. He said, how many World Cups have they had here? I think it's the first combined World Cup anyway. They had the Commonwealth Games here, and they had three major events. If you are wondering, this wonderful facility was built in 1982. It was actually updated for the Commonwealth Games in 2010, and it's really, really good. It's all grouped together. It's in a big compound about 25 kilometers from the center of New Delhi. And the conditions, just this is a fairly naive question, but we are inside a hall. The first 30 meters of the bullet is in temperature probably about, I don't know, it must be 20, 22 degrees in here at the moment. But then it goes out into the bright sunshine. Would that 30 meters outside, would that affect anything? Could powerful heat, could it raise the bullet a bit or not really?
The heat, no, not for this temperature and everything like that. It's more about the wind than anything. There's not, doesn't seem to be any mirage. So just the wind, and the flags are moving around a little bit now. So
when there is a mirage, is that panic time or is that?
It's not panic time, no, but it's, you definitely have to watch it. You know, the mirage can sometimes go in an opposite direction to the wind. So unless
your brain is calculating quite
usually that's the time to not shoot.
Okay, so at the moment the athletes have another couple of minutes. Will they be making adjustments?
They all look like they're getting pretty close to be sighted in now, so the sights are probably done and they're just making sure that they're shooting.
Sidi's just sort of a 10.9. So what does he do? Just sit back and relax? I suppose you can't be perfection.
No, you can't. No. I mean, relax. Some will, yes. But it's you can fill up the time with just making sure that you're in the right spot,
in the zone,
in the right rhythm,
yeah,
everything like that. You can use it to test what's happening with the wind as well. You can use all that time, any different conditions.
So you use up every single second of the 7 minutes you have, or the last couple of minutes you have.
Can, yeah, if you need to. And then, you know, last 30 seconds, just if you're ready, you can just just relax. And
the second series of shots, they are deemed to be able to fire more quickly in the praying position, so you have five shots in 150 seconds, or when the last shooter has actually shot. So you need significantly less time for this position.
It's a much more stable position, and you can see it can load and fire much quickly, so it makes sense that you have less time. About 30 seconds is plenty of time for a shot in prone.
All these athletes look like athletes, but the fact that they've been through quite a mental and physical strain already this morning, will they be starting to be tired?
No, you'll be tired afterwards. Time to be tired is afterwards. Now it's, I think you're so focused and on your job, what you're doing, you don't really pay too much attention to if you're
tired. If you look at Peter Sidi, who is in firing point F, and his bib is come undone on the back. Is that going to be annoying him?
I don't think he'll be focusing too much on that. It's probably a little. It could be annoying if it's sticking in his
like a little
neck,
fly or something.
Yeah, but he's very mentally strong, so.
Well, there you go. He just adjusted it. Should have go and have a word with him. Perhaps his bib, which is probably about 30 centimeters square, is actually sticking right up. Should have a close up in a minute.
He'll be fine.
So here we go. 150 seconds for five shots. It's going to be three series, and the score is clearly accumulated from the scores they already have from their 15 shots in the kneeling position. You can see 10.3, 10.3, 10.4, 9.6 from Yamashita. So you mentioned a couple of minutes ago 155 is a really good score in the kneeling position, and 157.5 is the sort of target you want to go for in the lying down, the prone position. So I'm not a mathematician. What's the average you need to be going for?
About 10.5. I mean, that's, you know, perfect world. 10.5 average is what you're looking for in prone.
So Peter City's first three shots averaging 10.1. Sun is 10.3. So they're not setting the world alight.
No.
They're consistent, aren't they? All athletes are in approximately the same range.
Correct, yeah.
Are the guns developing? Have they changed much since you started?
From when I first started, there's been a lot happen, yes, and always after each Olympics, everyone's trying new things and developing new things.
And so anything inside track on what people are trying this cycle?
There's a few new sights, things happening with sights, and as always manufacturers always doing something with the rifles, and you know, butt plates and cheek pieces. Everyone's trying to make it more simple and easier, better.
So how does it work? So Rio is obviously the end of the cycle. Is it from the next day of Rio they come back from the plane, or you come back from the plane because clearly you're in Rio and you suddenly throw away your old gun and start again, or do you?
No, absolutely not. No, it's maybe you don't change anything at all, especially if you're doing well. But if there's something that you think might help, then you've got plenty of time to try it, and it's not really going to affect any of the competitions coming up.
Well, we've had now the eight athletes who've now completed their first round of prone positions. They're not spectacular scores. We do have Sun Jian, who is increasing his lead. He has a 51.5, who has the best score, Sun 5. Andrew He from People's Republic of China struggled a little bit there with a 48.5. Peter Sidi is moving along nicely with 51.4. Anything to take away from that?
Not really.
They're all fairly bunched.
Yeah, it's hasn't made too much of a change to the positions.
If you look from third until fifth, three athlete fifth position, there's only point one. So they're really in the bunching
really
in the middle.
It's really tight. Yeah.
It'll start to be important soon because once we've had the standing, the first two series of 10, we're going to start eliminating. They're eliminating the seventh and eighth, and then it really gets down to business. So it's each shot's important, I guess.
Absolutely, it's definitely important to try and get as many points as you can in these first two kneeling and prone positions, so that if you do make a mistake in standing, you have a little bit of leeway.
Well, Pan Junkui had a bit of a problem before, but he just scored a 10.7, which helps him move up the board. 10.6 from Najushingpanger. 10, so they're all consistently firing in the tens.
You don't want to be shooting any nines in prone at this stage, no. Can't really afford.
Looking out at the second set of flags, it looks like the breeze has picked up a little bit. Will that
it
come into
look
play?
A bit more, it definitely would be a bit more breezy than the start, so they'll have to adjust to compensate for that.
Is that a question of adjusting your sights or just aiming a little bit left?
Bit of both, could nice. Be. Depends on what they decide.
Anything can we see from the grouping? It looks like Sidi now has managed to put quite a lot of shots in the well he wants to in the centre. 10.6 his last shot.
I have a feeling that Sidi is sort he'd be aiming off if it needs to. I mean, it could look this way, but it's hard to say unless you're shooting whether it's actually affecting it or not.
Just had a 10.9 there from the Thailand. Nappis has a score of 10.9, which is good. We'll know if Rajput scores really good scores because there's several hundred Indians hoping that he's going to go well in here. So that's the second series now of five shots. The athlete have now fired 25 shots. So Peter Sidi comes in with a 51.3. Last time he did a 51.4. We do have Rajput, who had the top score, near top score of the round, but Jan Lochbihler from Switzerland has a 52.5, so that's moved him up to provisional third position. Thanks for pointing out that.
That's what you're looking for. 52.5 is what you'd be looking for in prone.
Consistently?
Yeah.
So Sun is really taking quite a strong lead. But just for the 9.4, that's going to chop it down a bit.
Yeah, it's the gap is closing, definitely.
So Lochbihler has scored another 10.2. It's quite a low scoring round, this one. Peter Sidi came in with a 10.4. Followed by a 10.2. Now she'd had a 9.7, which won't help his cause.
The wind is definitely...
We can actually feel it in here, can't we? We can feel the breeze coming
in.
Yeah,
and you can see now it's making quite a difference with the shots.
Well, Sun Jian has just put two high left, which would you need to do something about that? Because they're both pretty much the same.
Yeah, definitely. It's the far flags are turned around the other way and pushing them out there.
Well, that's a 10 from Sacy. He's only had 28.6 out of the first three shots. So it's becoming interesting.
Yeah, very much so.
As long as it keeps fair.
It's going to be very close going into standing for sure.
Peter Sidi has now put his third round in. He's 51.3. So 51.4, 51.3, 51.3. You said they're only 52.5. At least he's consistent.
It's consistent, yeah. And obviously, comparison to everyone else. If you're shooting better than everyone else, then that's all that matters.
And he, as we know, is very strong when he's standing up. Rajput Sanjeev has just put in a 52.1, so his last two series have been excellent, really excellent.
That's good.
So that went very quickly. They've now finished their two out of three different positions. They finished their prone. They have 9 minutes now. How much do they actually need? And we have 2 minutes more because it's more complicated.
It is a little bit. You have a little bit more to do. Yes, yeah. You know, doing more with your clothes and everything to set up. From prone to standing is the biggest difference. So there can be the most amount of things to change on the rifle.
Do you have mentally? You clearly must know where you are. So are you mentally going through a routine, whatever you've scored before, saying, okay, I need to make sure I fix this on here, blah, blah, blah? Or are you examining, oh, no, I should have done better?
Really, because there's such a short amount of time, you're just changing your rifle, making focus on that you don't forget anything. And then...
Does this ever happen at this level? It shouldn't do, should it?
When we first started these new finals, I saw it a couple times, but it's very rare for it to happen now. I think everyone has practiced their routine so that they don't forget anything and manage it well.
So far, after the two positions, for the People's Republic of China, Sun Yujian is leading with 306.6. He's 1.08 ahead of Swiss Jan Lochbihler, and in third position it is India's Sanjeev Rajput. See if we can pick this up. Jamie Strangroom is interviewing Gagan, who has been coming here for 20 years now. Unfortunately, we can't pick it up, the volume of what he's actually saying.
No. I mean, he's great Indian shooter, but great shooter just in general. Really nice person as well. Very chilled guy.
Has, I believe, one of the largest academies in the country. One of his ideas. It's not-for-profit academy. So all the idea was... The story is fairly straightforward. It's when he started, his parents had to sell a plot of land to help him buy his very smart gun. And now, a few years later, he's trying to put something back into the sport. So yeah. Good on him.
I think he's got a lot out from the sport. And it's great to see him put it back into it. And he's doing a lot for Indian rifle shooting, for sure.
Back to the actual changeover. They've now had 3 minutes or so. And so they're just tightening the right clothes. These are really specific uniforms. Does everyone have pretty much the same? There's obviously very strict rules of what you can have. Of everyone having the same sort of setup with their clothing? Do you push it to the limit?
Generally, yes. I mean, there's like slightly different brands, and there's not much different that you can do. Maybe they have a slightly different cut in the tailoring for the gear, but generally everything's pretty much the same.
And they do look staggeringly beautiful. It's fashion, people. Why do most people wear white?
I don't know. I don't. I would think it gets much too dirty.
there are some of the athletes that... And is it easy to wash?
It could be if you do wash it, but not many people wash it because, you know, if it's either plastic or if it's canvas and you wet the canvas and then it changes the stiffness and you know, you're training the clothes to form in a certain way best to your position, so you don't really want to mess with that.
Well, we're now, all the athletes are in position. Do they know how to put the stance of their legs, or do some of them measure them?
Some have rules just to, as a more of a guide, you know, you still go by feeling. But if you have a rule there, then they feel more confident because they know then they're closer to the right position.
So what will they want to be doing now? We have a couple of minutes left. How many sighting shots do you think they'll want to fire off?
You want to have at least, you know, 5-6 good shots. 4.5 minutes is more than enough time to get, you know, 6 shots away. But definitely take some time to settle the body.
Let's just talk about you. With you personally, how old are you?
I'm 30.
You're 30. You look like very, very fit. So it's a heartbeat. How does your heartbeat go up and down during this competition?
Well, obviously it'll rise when you're moving around and changing the position. But at the start of the sighters, particularly, you're trying to just settle your body down and get your heart rate down so that your hold is as stable as possible. Around 60, you want it to be down around 60.
When you're actually firing?
When you're firing, yes, but obviously nerves and everything can
with the
make
adrenaline,
it rise.
I guess that doesn't bring it down, does it?
No. I've seen people shooting with a heartbeat of 150. Same competition, one person shooting 150 heartbeat, another having 85.
I suppose as long as you know how to manage it.
Exactly, yeah.
That's the key.
And it comes down to good triggering. If you pull the trigger in the right time, then the shot should be.
And is that a certain? I'm not a physician, but is that a certain beat, or is that during a certain beat, or is it always the same moment of the heartbeat?
It's when everything.
And breathing.
Is
how does breathing?
Still, it's all together. Breathing. I mean, breathing. You're just breathing normally, really. Just on the out breath is when you're firing the shot, because then the body is most settled, the muscles and everything are more relaxed.
Well, they're coming up to the point now. Looking at the grouping, are we seeing anyone who needs to panic? It looks like Lochbihler from Switzerland has really good grouping there.
It looks like he's shooting prone. It might be. I think that's left over from prone. I'm not sure if he's done actually any shots yet.
Okay. Well, if it was from here, it'd be spectacularly good. So last final few adjustments. And at this level, I guess 20 years ago, the athletes probably didn't have their own access to a psychologist. The fact that everyone has access to anything they like, has that actually upped the scores?
I think it all contributes to the rise in the scores, for sure. There's a lot getting more and more science into the sport as years go by, like with all sport. When you're getting higher and higher results, you need to look for finer and finer details to then be in front of everyone else. So
this course. So Jamie's just explaining now, but we will explain. The athletes have all had 30 shots, so they're moving into the final standing position. They're going to be taking 2 series of 5 shots, which will take them up to 40 shots each. That's going to be in 250 seconds per series. And after the second one, we're going to say goodbye to the 8th and the 7th athlete.
Correct. Yeah.
So this is the case of, at the moment, 7th Peter Sidi and 8th the People's Republic of China is Pang Yuhi. Pang Yuhi is 3 points down, so that's quite a bit to make up.
On the scoreboard, it looks like quite a bit, but in standing, it can you could possibly, depending on how the others go, make that up in one 5-shot series.
We'll have to see how it pans out.
30
The city's sighters look really quite good. Like I said before, he's strong standing shooter. So.
Shortly, our first series in this competition will take place at Hammer. We'll look at scores again. So,
So how do you see these scores coming through?
There's some decent gap between 8th and 1st that might be a bit much to make up. But on the top half of the board, it's really close. And I think you'll see quite a few place changes.
Do any of these athletes, do you know from experience, tend to move up the board in this last standing position?
Sidi, yes.
Well, he has to, isn't he? Otherwise, he's going to say goodbye.
Yeah. Chinese and for sure Yamashita is good standing shooter as well.
The music, is it just one of those things you all train with now?
Yeah, my coach is always putting music on. It's good. I think it's good to have the music going, and it's a bit much like a surgery otherwise.
I guess if you day in, day out, you need to keep yourself motivated, keep light tone. San Jian is still leading. Rajput just put in a 10.2 for India. Peter Sidi, 9.8. The conditions, are they dictating that it's quite difficult out there? Lots of late nines coming into it.
No, I mean, the conditions have changed definitely from prone. They seem to have settled down and the wind's changed direction a little bit. But the biggest variable in standing is your body movement.
And are they all managing to control as we see?
Some are, some not so much. Pan has got a couple of one bad shot down low.
Yamashita is moving up nicely with a 10.5, as you saw.
Yeah, Yamashita has got a nice tight group, and Yan as well.
He just scored a 10.5 as well. Lochbihler 10.3. Yamashita's come through with a 50. What are we looking to score on this? About a 51 to be really, really competitive?
To be really competitive, I mean 51, but today I think with the conditions and everything, 50.0 would be, and up is quite solid.
And here we see Jan Lochbihler from Switzerland, can't read his body language. In deep thought.
He's working, yeah.
The brain's calculating what needs to go on. So, for the first time, Jan Lochbihler has moved into the first place. So, we're going to lose two athletes after this next series. So far, Peter Sidi is in 7th place, 350.2, and Fang Yuhu for China is a little bit off the pace at the moment.
That 3.6 is a bit much to make up. I think something pretty dramatic would have to happen for him to be saved.
But the pictures are all on Switzerland at the moment as they're leading out from two Chinese athletes. This is a first World Cup final, I believe. He did go to Rio, which is always a boost. But he's certainly finding himself in new ground here.
He's very good shooter as well. Maybe just unlucky sometimes to just miss out on a final. But
look at that, 10.5 for his first shot. So it's a
he's shooting well today for sure.
At the bottom, Peter Sidi needs to make up still a fair bit, and he's coming in with 20.3 in his first two shots. 9.8 from Pan, from People's Republic of China. Looks like it's not going to be enough. Peter Sidi needs to make up 1.1 in the last three shots from Yamashita if he's going to survive.
Which it could happen. It's certainly not out, not reasonable, not...
Well, he's coming with a third shot, it's a 10.4.
Yep.
Yeah, Yamashita did 9.1, that could change things around.
It is.
It's changed in one shot.
Yeah, one shot,
like
yeah.
You told the future. Yamashita's really having a few problems out there. 27.9 in three shots. Pan is firing the slowest out there. Still a big deficit to make up. So Peter Sidi is putting in a good series of shots. This one a 10. Yamashita's 9.3. So Peter Sidi has a 0.9 space with one shot to go in this series, which we'll see the 7th and 8th eliminated. Peter Sidi is putting 9.2 just to keep it interesting. Really, it's going to come down to the last shot. Yeah.
If Yamashita shoots a 10.2.
Oh, he's done it, he's on 10.5.
Ah, there you go.
Wow, just in one of the last shot. Peter Sidi came back, but it looks like it's game over.
Yeah.
Well, there's maybe a surprise, but maybe not.
No, I mean it's so difficult to predict what will happen, because everyone's good shooters, everyone's capable of shooting good scores. So
Lochbihler needs to take his last shot, which was a 9.7. It does mean we had a slight change at the top. So Sun is now leading from Lochbihler from Switzerland. Rui is in third place. But unfortunately, we do have to say goodbye to two athletes. Pan Zhenghui bows out in eighth place for the People's Republic of China. Peter Sidi takes seventh place. A lot of ups and downs in the last few minutes, Peter Sidi. Takes the seventh place today. So now it's a case of every shot we lose some.
Yeah, correct. So it's and it's still really quite close between almost everybody. So like we saw before, you can change a whole point with one shot. So
you can see the differences. There's 0.9, 1, 0.5, 1.8, and 0.8. So they're all with the shots they've been having. I think we have some suspense to come in the next 5 minutes. Yamashita at the moment is, I guess, the athlete with the most pressure on his shoulders. The Indian crowd certainly won't be wishing him luck. We had Rajput slightly above on. Sound with a 10.3. Yamashita 9.7. Rajput just needs safe. No. Yamashita's going to leave the tournament. Rajput fighting for another day. Six, please. Toshiaku Yamashita from Japan. Five athletes left to go. Who's in the four seeds? It's Sanjeev Rajput, who just scraped through in the qualifications in his last shot, so he has luck on his side today.
He might have used it all, though.
We'll have to see in a couple of seconds, won't we? What's the gap? 1.2. For the next competition shot, blue. Here he is. He needs to make up a deficit of 1.2.
I'd like to hear what the crowd does if he shoots a
you will,
really good 10.
You will. Luckily we have protective earplugs in here.
Yeah.
Everyone's holding their breath. Tortungpanich. He's got a 9.2, so Tortungpanich only needs to score an 8 point. Ooh, it's going to be really close.
Oh. 0.1.
Oh, so close. Huh. Well, fifth place for India. Sanjeev Rajput goes out by 0.1, the smallest margin. Wow, so for Thailand, you can stay in the competition with an 8. So we have now four athletes left in the competition. The gap between the fourth and third place is 1.8. Switzerland in the threatening seat. They're keeping their heartbeats down to 60, you think?
Probably not.
Well, here we go. Tortungpanich. Sun comes off with a 9. He's leading at the moment. 10.7. It certainly closes the gap a lot. 8.8 from Tortungpanich and an 8.7 from Lochbihler. Say fourth place representing Thailand, Nappis, Tortungpanich. We know the medalists. We know Switzerland have a medal. And I should just put replay on here.
Yeah.
People in the Republic of China have already won 4 golds so far. They're certainly going to win 2 more medals. Quite a gap, unfortunately, for Jan Lochbihler from Switzerland. A 2.6 gap between third and second place, but it couldn't be tighter for the first and second, 0.1. For the next competition shot, look. Years old. Swiss Jan Lochbihler needs to have the shot of his life. And you wouldn't bet against China messing up, would you?
No, not normally.
Well, they're not great, no. But no, goes out with a 9. However, it is a bronze medal, which is pretty good effort.
Yeah, it's excellent. Yeah.
First final, and takes a medal.
I think he'll be happy.
Lochbihler.
Yeah, he's happy.
With your very first final. So, a bit of a leapfrogging in the last situation. We do, at the moment, have Hui Tsitsung, who is now in the driving seat. Last shot and 0.9 between them. We have seen this overcome several times.
I mean, it's a nice place to be. You know, if you come second, then your teammate is coming first. So, it's I feel like they'd be able to relax a small amount.
Well, we'll see how they go on. It's a deficit 0.9 at the moment. Sun and Hui. Sun 8.9. Hui needs a 7.9 to win. Keeping us going here.
Yeah.
Oh, 10.6. So he kept going a little bit more, but a great result there. Kui Tsitong takes the gold medal. Where he's won five other golds. That's his sixth gold in a World Cup final. So he came in as the top performer. But we do have three medalists there. We have China, and Switzerland. China now takes its fifth gold medal. So bronze medal, as you can hear, for Switzerland. Lochbihler takes the bronze medal. Can't quite see him off picture. Silver medal, as you can see on the image. There you are, standing all together. And it's Sung Jin who takes the bronze medal, silver medal, sorry, and overtaking in the last couple of shots, the gold medal for the People's Republic of China, Hui Tsitong. Well, that's been a fun day. Dane, thank you very much for you coming in and giving us the benefit of your knowledge. It's been really, really good. Hope you've all enjoyed yourself at home. We can go back to social media and tell us what you think, tell us how happy you are, and we'll be looking forward to seeing you tomorrow. We're coming live from New Delhi. Thanks, I'm Matthew Layton. Thanks to Dane Sampson for coming in, and we'll speak to you soon.